fabrication of short labial bow. These are the armamentarium required. Dispense the wire from spool. Measure the wire from one molar across to another molar area along the labial or buccal surface of the teeth and cut it with a wire cutter. Use this piece of wire to fabricate the labial bow. Using fingers from a bow, adapting it onto the labial surface of the incisors at about the junction of middle and incisor thirds of the teeth. Place two masks on the bow corresponding to the contact points between the lateral incisors and canine on either side. Place two right-angled bends, that is 90-degree bends, on the bow at the points marked. The bend should be towards the gingival margin. Make a margin on the vertical arm at about 2 mm. Beyond the free gingival margins on either side. Form the loops at the marked points using a round, weak Young's loop bending plier. The loop should be formed above the gingival margins and should be short of the sulcus to prevent irritation of the soft tissues. Care should also be taken to keep it away from the frenum or muscle attachments. The distal arm of the vertical loop is adapted onto the palatal or the lingual surface of the cast to form the tags as in case of any clasp construction. Care is taken to see that the labial bow remains at the junction of middle and incisal thirds of the labial surface of the anterior teeth while adapting the tag or retentive arm. The labial bows are mainly used for the retraction and retention of the teeth. The type of a labial bow selected for a case depends upon the following factors. For example, number of teeth to be moved, severity of the protrusion of teeth, purpose of labial bow, location of spacing of the teeth, preference of the clinician. Thank you.